Have you ever had this experience? You're too busy to research. You don't want to reduce your playtime just to gather information. Even if you find it, the information is outdated and useless. That behavior pattern can be changed. Hello, everyone. In this video, we have created a video introducing the Conqueror's Blade FAQ BOT, a tool that anyone can easily use. Unlike casual games, this game requires you to understand the map terrain, the characteristics of different units, tactics for each map, and the compatibility of different units, all while controlling your troops and fighting as a hero. Because of this, the game is extremely difficult for beginners. Normally, you would learn various things through a tutorial, but the tutorial in this game is not very well made, so you have to research and learn by watching streams, videos, and other external sources on your own. This time, I will introduce a tool that allows even beginners or less skilled players to easily look things up and improve quickly. First, please watch this video.
Today, we're excited to share Project GAssist, a demo showcasing how developers can enhance games and apps with AI assistance. Many games offer vast universes and rich gameplay systems to explore, each with its own intricacies and mechanics. Depth has become the cornerstone of some of the most captivating gaming experiences. Whether it's a new player trying a game for the first time, overwhelmed by massive skill trees, or a seasoned veteran looking for that perfect weapon to min-max that DPS build, many of us spend hours researching, scouring the internet to learn, to dig deeper, and ultimately enjoy more of what the game has to offer. This is where Project GAssist comes in. It uses AI to make sure information is readily available whenever we need it. It works by taking in speech or a text prompt from the player, along with context from the screen, and then it feeds this into a large language model that is enhanced by the developer's game knowledge database. These AI models can run on the cloud or locally, accelerated by your GeForce RTX GPU. To show you what's possible, we've partnered with Studio Wildcard for a tech demonstration using Arc Survival Ascended. The assistant is your conduit for game-specific knowledge. You can ask it questions you often find yourself looking up online, like, what's the best early game weapon and where do I find the crafting materials for it?
The best early game weapon is the spear. It provides knockback and is essential for survival.
Not only does it know about the game, it can understand what's happening on the screen. Maybe you're staring at a dinosaur you're not familiar with and you want to know what it is or how to tame it. And because the assistant is context-aware, it can tailor its recommendations to your playthrough. Say you've racked up enough points to level up or to unlock a crafting recipe, but you're just not sure what to go for next. And if you want to dive deeper into a topic, you can simply click on the response to learn more at the official Wiki, for instance. Project GAssist is a glimpse into that future.
Wouldn't it be great if there were a tool like this in Conqueror's Blade to make things easier for beginners? With that in mind, I created an FAQ BOT using NotebookLM as a hobby project. And here it is. Big or small, round or flat, if it's in my world, then that's a fact. Kawaii sky. Just like this. It should make it easier for not only beginners but also veteran players to search for information. This tool was created using NotebookLM, which Google is currently offering for free. By uploading multiple documents, summarizing them, and asking questions about them, you can use it as if you have your own personal military strategist assistant. There are similar tools, such as ChatGPT. ChatGPT can answer a wide range of questions, but since it derives its answers based on massive training data and internet searches, the accuracy of its responses can sometimes be questionable. On the other hand, NotebookLM provides answers based on the sources you specify, allowing you to obtain more reliable information. Furthermore, it uses Gemini 2.0, making multilingual support simple. In other words, if the information you upload is correct, this tool can become incredibly useful. Of course, it can also be shared with others. However, since I am assuming the use of the free version this time, it cannot cover the entire Conqueror's Blade player base. Therefore, I will provide the source data, and each person will set it up and use it individually. First, open NotebookLM. If you have a Google account, you should be able to use it easily, so please open it from the link in the description. Once NotebookLM starts up, the first step is to register the links to the source files. I have included the links in the description, so just copy and paste them. You can register sources on the left side of the screen, and if you have registered 3 sources, then you're done. That's all for the setup. Now, let's try using it. But before that, I have a sudden question. Why is it that only beginners or less skilled players always want to use Havas Crossbowmen? This unit's performance does not match its cost. I don't know why people are so eager to unlock it, but I am going to prove that this unit is not as strong as its cost suggests so that beginners do not copy weaker players. The first reason is that it is powerless against shielded enemies. For some reason, weaker players tend to challenge shielded enemies. As you can see in the video, they cannot get any kills at all. By the way, if you try this against Spartan Chosen, their skill gauge will fill up quickly, making it easy for them to massacre your allies. Therefore, if you don't have many units yet, I recommend using Iron Reapers or Shinji Grenadiers. The second reason is that it lacks firepower compared to lower tier units. It clears enemies faster than 3-star crossbowmen. Its clearing speed is the same as 4-star archers. Now that we're ready, let's try using it. Of course, it supports Japanese. Additionally, it can translate and summarize YouTube videos. For now, I am providing data limited to basic information and siege battles. In the future, I am thinking of adding more data related to siege battle strategies. If you find anything odd while using it, please leave a comment.